Home hospitals and food pantries are preparing for the COVID-19 public health emergency to be over.
Well, that emergency declaration also ends tomorrow. KNBC9's Alan Chope is getting answers on the changes you'll start to see.
I think the cooperation was unprecedented.
For hospitals like University Health, it's been nearly 1,200 days of working emergency status.
It's been something, that's for certain.
During the pandemic, the hospital provided 271,000 COVID tests and nearly 150,000 doses of vaccine.
Learned a lot from this experience, there's no doubt about that.
Well, Dr. Adge, it's tough to put into words what healthcare workers have gone through the last 3+ years.
We found out that with a pandemic that we can come together and quickly operationalize things.
That number will probably increase for us.
Joe Hickey with JFS says they're clientele list will grow now with many federally funded relief sources expiring, like extra funding through the SNAP program for families to get money for groceries.
An extra $120 a month can go a really long way.
For some area food pantries like JFS and Brookside, the official end of the pandemic might mean stocking up for some. Many pantries receiving donations and grants from the CARES Act and other emergency assistance funds.
I can't speak to exactly what that will look like in the next few months for us.
She adds families and organizations getting the extra funding will now have to find new ways to work with what they've got in the post-pandemic assistance world.
How are area nonprofits able to help meet some of those other needs that the families are finding?
In Kansas City, Alan Chope, KNBC9 News.
University Health says at the height of the pandemic on January 1st, 2022, the hospital cared for 190 COVID-positive inpatients, and right now they have fewer than 5 in isolation.